The Drum Corps History Podcast, Episode 32. The Drum Corps History Podcast, a deeper look into Drum Corps history. This week's episode, A History of Drum Corps Associates, Part 2. Welcome back to the Drum Corps History Podcast. My name is Ron Allard from Dice Man Radio. The following comes in part from an article written by Tom Pesci for A History of Drum and Bugle Corps, Volume 2, published by Steve Vickers of Drum Corps World. Throughout the closing years of the 20th century, DCA continued to grow and prosper. Overall, corps got larger and better. The Bushwhackers' dominance was broken in 1991 with the first world championship for Vince Bruni's Empire Statesman, the self-proclaimed showman of the world. Bushwhackers stormed back in 1992 and 1993, and Empire won again in 1994. The mid-1990s saw a powerful Hawthorne Corps win in 1995, only to be nipped in 1996 by the West Shoremen. We'll be right back. The 1992 season had seen the re-entry of the Syracuse Brigadiers. Their steady growth culminated in 1997 with a share of the title with the Empire Statesmen. Empire was able to defend in 1998, but the Brigadiers closed out the century by winning the DCA championship in 1999. With strong leadership, stable cores, an abundance of sponsors, and a solid commitment to entertaining its audiences, DCA moved boldly into the new century. The Brigadiers cemented their place in history with 4 championship victories in a row, a feat unprecedented in DCA, and winning 5 championships in 6 years. Although the Brigadiers dominated in 2000, 2001, and 2002, it is obvious that the senior corps raised the bar on quality. What was in the 1980s a clear quality break between the bottom and top half of the membership has melted to a parity and quality never seen before. From the first corps on the field to the end of the retreat ceremony, fans have been delighted with the overall quality of the programs, the competitiveness within the ranks, and the dedication of the members to true drum corps. The emergence of more corps from other areas became clear. Heat Wave of Orlando, Corvettes of Atlanta, and Carolina Gold of Raleigh, North Carolina created a solid block in the South. In recognition of this, DCA established its first subsidiary regional organization, DCA South, for 2003. After 20 years of successful participation in the DCA championships, Minnesota Brass brought high standards from the Midwest. With the addition of the Racine Kilties, the Governors, and Chops Incorporated, a DCI Midwest circuit also became a reality. The strong impact the San Francisco Renegades made in 2002, becoming the first member corps from the West Coast, cannot go unnoticed. With more than 70 brass performers, they won over the audience and entertained to the hilt. While DCA's many fine Canadian members have always added a touch of international flavor to DCA, three times corps have successfully competed in DCA from other continents. First, in 1990, a very strong Southern Knights of Brighton, UK finished 12th in the preliminary competition and became the first international champions of DCA. The 2002 championship saw the first Japanese corps attend. Yokohama Inspires brought over a tight 81-member corps and won over the hearts of the fans and competitors alike. Appearing early in the prelims, their strong 8th-place finish was a shock to everyone, but that was only the beginning. While admitting freely that they were formed as a Caballero copycat by members who had attended championships many years earlier, they went on to not only get to visit with their idols and perform and party with their stylistic counterparts in the parking lot of their hotel, but they also beat the Caballeros in finals with an inspired performance where they jumped to 5th. They were crowned the 2nd ever international DCA champion. In 2010, while celebrating their 100th anniversary as an organization, the Kids Grove Scouts of Stoke-on-Kent, UK, came to Rochester, New York for the DCA Championships. They placed sixth in finals and became our third international champion. Following the 1996 season, DCA decided to try harder to encourage the growth of other senior corps throughout the country. As part of this effort, a Class A championship was instituted. Restricted to only 65 performers, Class A offers the opportunity for success to the smaller but up-and-coming corps. It creates an avenue of competition that allows these small corps to improve and grow. Beginning with the 2001 season, the Class A Championship was removed from its previous Saturday morning position as part of the Open Class Preliminary Competition. As of now, the top four scoring Class A corps on Saturday get to compete in a championship runoff on Sunday night as part of an overall finals concept. This entire endeavor has been most successful. It has worked from several different angles and has created corps that have become stable and successful competitors despite being small in numbers like Orlando's Heat Wave. In the late 1980s, DCA began running their own individual and ensemble contest during championship weekend. This was the brainchild of former judging coordinator Dick Pronti. He recruited chairperson Donna Ernst of upstate New York, and she developed a successful program into a major part of the championship experience. After the first few years, a separate part of the contest was invented called MiniCore. This caught on quickly and has created an entirely new avenue of fun and entertainment. Small ensembles of 21 performers or less perform on stage and actually compete against each other. This takeoff on the old winter concert series of days gone by has now become a very popular part of DCA. Competing corps, alumni corps, and parade corps are all welcome to compete. Three of the most successful are the Erie Thunderbirds from their alumni corps, the Ghost Riders from Mighty St. Joe's alumni, and the current champion, Star United, who have won the contest every year they appeared. When the first alumni corps appeared in the 1980s, DCA was not quick to embrace them. However, through the hard work of Mickey Patrone, DCA became a major proponent of the alumni corps movement, and the DCA Alumni Spectacular held each year the day of the championship finals has become an annual tribute to the history of our activity. This is the opportunity for the DCA fans to remember, respect, and pay tribute to times past and the performers who made those memories special.
We'll be right back.
So, what will the future bring? Change is inevitable. Change is part of life. DCA finds itself in the enviable position of benefiting from the changes in lifestyle that are making it so difficult to succeed in any activity. Financial hardships, demands on everyday lifestyles, year-round school activities, and the ever-increasing variety of things to do have all made it most difficult to survive. Functioning as nonprofit organizations, drum corps are not immune to the difficulties of the times. For all nonprofit organizations, fundraising becomes more difficult each year while expenses spiral out of control. This has increased the demand for weekend-only corps, and this has increased the demand for geographically central performance venues. This has made senior, or if you prefer, all-age corps a much more viable entity. These restrictions on what can be done by performers who have jobs and families have crossed over from being huge negatives to becoming positive recruiting tools. The difficulty and enormous expense in traveling and lack of performance opportunities has caused another new phenomena. For the past few seasons, DCA has allowed a few junior corps to participate in DCA-sanctioned contests. For the most part, this experiment has been successful and will continue. While this may not lead to a full junior corps division, the cooperation between DCA and the junior activity is at an all-time high and has been mutually beneficial. Through the years, DCA has had some of the finest adjudicators in the business. Hall of Fame greats like John Cullum, Walter Kelly, and Truman Crawford use DCA as home base. With DCA taking control of the rules that corps are judged by, it has been critical that DCA find the best possible judging coordinators to advise on the appropriate judging system for senior corps, recruit and educate experienced qualified judges, and administrator the entire judging program. It is this control of the adjudicative process that has allowed DCA to keep its programs audience-friendly but still challenging the performers and the staff. The intentional emphasis on general effect has set DCA apart from other areas of the marching medium. It is critical that its adjudicators understand this and respond to the edict set by the member corps to first and foremost entertain the audience. That concludes this week's episode on A History of DCA, Part 2. Please join us again next time as we take a deeper look into drum corps history. This podcast is produced and sponsored by DiceManRadio.com.